Well, last November, troops from Cameroon discovered some 80 children alone in what was believed to be a Boko Haram camp. The children had been stripped of their identities and indoctrinated with jihadist ideology. Christopher Fomunyoh recently had the opportunity to meet the children at an orphanage. He's a senior associate with the National Democratic Institute here in the United States. Take a look.
I was led to this camp where I saw children from the ages of 5 through 18, who really have been disconnected from the rest of the world in a sense that they can't read or write, they cannot speak French or English, they have even difficulty expressing themselves in the local language. The instructor of this orphanage told me that the kids can understand some form of Arabic, because apparently when they were in this camp, they were studying the Quran in Arabic. The instructors at this orphanage told me that it's difficult to have them identify themselves just because they can't speak. You can't have a normal conversation with them. They have no identification papers. And apparently they've changed names many times over in different years as they've moved from location to location. Many of them also cannot even remember the villages that they came from. So it's going to be a lot of effort to try to reconnect them with their parents or the villages of origin, and it's a daunting task that probably would not be done in the short term. I think we have to put it in context, in the context of a government that has never had to deal with this kind of crisis in the past. And right now, as I was told at the camp, the priority is just to give them the basic necessities, the very basic necessities of even having a meal a day, and clothing to wear. But as you can see from the pictures, even the clothing that they have is just deplorable. But I don't think that the people at the camp have the resources or have even thought through how to help these kids reconnect or reconnect with society. It's very heart-wrenching, but it also, I think for me, it also captures the complexity of the Boko Haram crisis, and it foreshadows the warning that even if in the short term the Boko Haram crisis is resolved militarily, it's going to take a lot of effort in the medium to long term to deal with all of the collateral damage that has been caused to the human condition in the northeastern part of Cameroon because of the Boko Haram crisis.